In fact, I have been approached by President Ali Abdullah Saleh some years ago, and he asked me if I could persuade Anwar to come to live in Sana'a or in Aden. Anwar was living in Al-Sa'id in Awlaki territory, and he was living peacefully, going to the mosque, meeting people in a small village. And in fact, and he told me, please try and convince him, we want him to come and live in Sana'a. And the Americans, they don't want him to live in his in the Awlaki Sheikhdom. So I went, I met Anwar, I spoke to him, and he told me, uncle, please, I got bored by living in Sana'a. I have been in jail for a long time, and they could not prove anything to me, and I am afraid if I go back to Sana'a, they will put me in jail again. So I want to be alone here in this peaceful village, and please assure them that I have nothing to do whatsoever with Al-Qaeda. I know nothing about it, but if I hope they don't force me to go to the end. I tried to convince him that he will be in peace, but he said, I don't trust neither the American government nor the Yemeni government for my safety, and just tell them that I have nothing to do whatsoever with Al-Qaeda. And all I do, I do it openly. I go to the mosque, I meet people, and that's all.
Sheikh Salah bin Farid, if the U.S. government had presented you with evidence, would you have turned Anwar al-Awlaki over to U.S. forces or to the Yemeni government?
For sure, I would have done it. And I am sure his father would have done it. I have known Anwar for a long time, since he was a child. Anwar was—he was born, to be honest, he was born to be a leader. He was a very promising young man. He was loved by the people all over the country, by the tribesmen, by the religious people, by the politicians. And he was welcomed anywhere he would go. But I assure you, he got nothing whatsoever to do for what they claim. And I am sure I could have handed him over, me and my family. But they never, ever asked us to do that.
Nasser al-Awlaki, let me ask you the same question. You're the father of Anwar al-Awlaki. If the U.S. government had presented you with evidence and you were convinced, would you have handed your son over?
Well, you know, if we go back, you know, when I wrote the letter to Mr. Obama telling him not to target my son, and I asked him to give me some time to have a dialogue with my son and convince him to not to make any ceremonies, even ceremonies against the United States of America or any other country. Yet, I got no response from the United States government. So there was no effort on the side of the United States government that they wanted to capture Anwar and put him to trial if they had anything against him. So believe me, if the United States government gave me a concrete evidence against Anwar, I would have done my best to convince Anwar to come to Sana'a or to go even to the United States and face a trial. But it was only allegations. For example, Mr. Obama in his speech claimed that Anwar was the foreign director of Al-Qaeda operations in Yemen. This is a big lie. Al-Qaeda never claimed that Anwar is a member of their organization. They always called him a Sheikh Anwar al-Awlaghi. They never claimed he is a member of their organization. They never said he had an office or any official standing in that organization. Even Anwar himself.